What's going on, YouTube? What's going on, Patreon friends? How are we all doing today? What's going on with my gospel group, man? We're doing some more Karen Clark. Is it Sheard? I think it's Sheard, right? Oh man, I'm all over my words tonight. Hold on. Cheers, everyone. All right. This was a special request from my friend Jeremy on Patreon, Jeremy Jenkins. I appreciate this. I always appreciate the gospel, man. Gospel is something that, gospel and soul are both genres that, like, I don't know why I don't listen to, like, super often on my own time, but it's some of, like, the, like, I don't know, how do I say this? Like, for me to enjoy listening to, like, when someone bestows it upon me, it's some of my favorite, man. Like, not even kidding. Like, I think y'all can tell, man, I'm about to break my neck in half these gospel songs. So I appreciate the request. I appreciate the support from everyone at Patreon. If y'all want to check me out, if y'all like this kind of content, you can check out the link in my description box. We're going to get into some of this tech stuff here. It's typically what I get into. This is, if you're new here, if you're coming back to watch me just bang head and break my neck, let's go. Let's do this. I'm going to pull this up. I'm going to stop talking. Let's do this. Okay. This crowd too. Man, this is like, all this is so tasty. Like, there's something about this hi-hat. Like, I listen to a band called Supertramp, man, and it's just like, I get into their hi-hat so much. There's something about what's going on with this, like, they're like 30-second notes on top of, like, this kind of, like, halftime beat. Karen sounds fantastic. She looks fantastic, too. I'm excited to see the whole outfit here. Drummer's going off. I think there's a percussion player too. I'm excited to see this whole band. This choir sounds fantastic. I think this is what I love about this kind of music, man, because anytime you get like 4, 5, 6, 10, 12, 15, 20 voices, man, there's just something about it that gives me friggin' goosebumps. Like, at least this section, the words that I'm catching, it feels very, like, supportive, and it's cool to hear her singing with a smile, because it feels like she's talking with a smile. Like, I have a smile all the time, but it gives my voice a certain kind of inflection, and, like, you can hear it in her singing voice too, right? It's cool, man. It's cool. Oh, man. I just want to take a second to say I just appreciate all the outfits, all the looks, like, everything that's going on here, man. It's fantastic. I love this. Her natural singing position or placement, I guess, like, for pitches on the piano must be, like, really high, man, because it sounds like she's just getting into her mixed voice for some of these, like, high notes. And, like, to be able to, like, hit these clean notes without, like, vibrato or anything, just, like, confidently just, like, let these notes just sail, like, it's just so impressive, man. And I just, like, I never, ever, ever get tired of it. It's also, I'm going to talk about, like, the PA and the production and stuff a little later, but it's weird. It's kind of weird seeing the singer above or, like, level with the top of the PA. You just don't see it too often. I'll point it out. groove. This groove I wanted to talk about. I'll save it because I just paused. But this groove, man. He's a This is all that gospel stuff that I talk about, like these gospel fills. Like I talk about this in lots of the Anderson .Paak stuff, man, because he's got like church roots written all over his playing, and it's like it's all this stuff, man, and it's wild to me, and it's so cool. I think it's so cool that a lot of like that art, like that, those fills, that capacity, like to learn that is mostly just like grandfathered down, man. Like it's mentored in, and it's like I can't figure them out. I've had drum teachers explain gospel fills to me. I've had like gospel drummers explain them to me, sit down with a drum kit facing each other, and I just can't make them sound like this. It's just, it never ceases to amaze me, man. Like these drummers, all these musicians that come out of these like these churches, man, and like all these like these places, these houses of God and stuff, man. It's just unreal. The passion, bro. The passion. There's no top. Like she's not gonna run out of room. I don't know if there's a note she couldn't hit. At least that wouldn't be fitting for the song, you know what I mean? Like, come on, man. Big Ben, man, it's cool to see that she like had like a physical, like her jaw moved a lot with that Big Ben too. It sounded great, man. It sounded fantastic. She sounds so confident. I was gonna say, man. Like giving me like saxophone, like lead saxophone vibes right now, man. It's just wild. Someone said something to me that I thought was really profound in high school, my band teacher, man. He said that every instrument is trying to replicate a voice because the voice can tell you what it's thinking. You know what I mean? I can use my words to describe while I sing. And like, it's neat to see when people go the other way. Like if you take that as like 100%, right? Which like, if you take it as 100%, it's like when now the vocalist is trying to sound like the saxophone, it's like the roles are kind of reversed, right? It's kind of neat. Like in my opinion, camera changes on me and I can't really see the monitor because I get into the thing too much, so I'm gonna back up a bit and I'm gonna talk about my point. Here we go. Man, even like, you know, the video quality, like it is what it is, right? Like it's probably like an older video, like 240 is as high as it goes, but you can still see that she's got a lot of technique in her singing. And I know again that she doesn't need my affirmations, that's not why we're here, but like it's interesting to see, because like when you start getting that like rasp in your voice, there's a couple ways you can do it so that you can protect your voice from getting like nodes and damage and strain and stuff. And one of them is like a part of it is that you have to press your tongue into the back of your teeth, or you do, like you don't have to, but like a part of it is that you can press your tongue into the back of your teeth and you get this very like pressed forward feeling, and then your embouchure starts like compressing the air differently and it pushes it differently in your vocal cords. And you can see her doing this, like her tongue is like laid against her teeth, man, and you can hear like these big like, You know, like, I wouldn't be able to sing that with my tongue at the bottom of my mouth. Like, it just, it wouldn't be the same. It would just be different. It wouldn't have the same kind of, like, intensity. And, she, like, to be fair, the notes that she's hitting, if there was any comparison, she is, like, she would outwalk me in, like, tone and everything, right? So it's just, like, it's neat to see, like, the technique. It's neat to be able to capture the technique like that, right? Gets me hyped. And then, like, she's using, like, her nose for, like, a little bit of that, like, yeah. I'm trying to over-accentuate a little bit. I don't mean to sound whatever. But it's neat because it's just, like, it's another method of changing how your voice sounds. And it's neat because, like, we get to hear it and we get to see it, right? See how much darker it sounds now? Her tongue is dropped and she still has that, like, that rasp, like, that soulful kind of rasp to her, right? But, like, her tongue is dropped and now it's so much darker sounding. I couldn't do it. I'll sit here and hack my lungs out. This groove is so tight, man. Like, I dig all the shots that they do, like, so where it's like one bow on this, like, big two. Like, there's something about, like, again, like, back to the, like, Bruno Mars, Anderson .Paak thing. They do that lots too, like, especially in their live stuff. It just gives, like, a certain energy, man. And it's like they're so locked in, and then they have these, like, tight runs. You can hear the guitar players in there too, keyboards too, and it's like not one, like, note is fudged. Like, everything is just so precise, man. This whole thing is just, like, fantastic. See, this is what I mean. The PA's, like, here, the band pit's down here, and then she's singing up on the stage, and there's, like, the choir's up above. It's just weird seeing, like, the PA at, like, you know, performance level, right? It's just, you don't see it too often. I've got a theory about, like, how people's, like, the bridge of their nose sounds, and if it makes, like, when they're singing like this sound shrill or not. And she has, like, a, like, in my opinion, if that theory or if there is any science behind that, I have no clue. I just, like, I'm just, like, kind of deciding that that's a fact. But if so, man, I think she would have, like, she would have a beautiful bridge for this, because, like, she can bark, man, she could bite, she could do all this, like, really high stuff, and it's never too shrill. And, like, I would expect that you could probably alleviate some of that through to just, like, practice, rehearsal, like, dedication to the craft. But, like, in my opinion, you have to rely on your nose for, like, some of it to not sound shrill. And then when you have, like, a good sounding bridge, or like a very good fitting bridge for being a singer, like she would, like Karen would, I think that adds to it. And that's my personal opinion. I'd love to hear what anyone else thinks. Too, man, that'd be me too. I would just be sitting there with this big smile on my face, just losing my lid dancing. Fantastic, man. Fantastic. Great, man. This is so embarrassing. Great, man. Fantastic performance. Fantastic request. I appreciate that. One of the things that I think is cool, man, is like I was saying, like the orientation of how they have it set up. So like, you know, Karen singing on the stage, the choir behind her, that's cool. But then like it wasn't like a hung PA. And I don't know if it was just before they kind of started doing that all the time in like installs and stuff. It doesn't really matter as long as you're not in front of the speaker, right? But like having the band in the pit down below kind of gives you a lot of like opportunity to let bands kind of show off a little bit. And you can bury amps like underneath the stage, looking backwards, like just shooting straight into the frame of the stage. And then you can have like a lot better tones and a lot better sounds, right? So it was cool to see like the musician pit set up as well. And like I dug it, man. I thought it was cool. I thought it looked like they had a dynamic microphone called a Shure SM58. Like it looked like it had a bunch of them in front of the choir. And it's just so interesting because like you'd think, based on like how dynamic microphones work, you kind of have to be like right in front of them for them to like really, really sound the way that they're supposed to sound. So you'd think if there was one here and three voices around it, it would pick up this person's voice a lot. And these ones not as much, just because it's out of the polar pattern. But like, I don't know, man, it sounded like a ton of voices. It looked like a ton of voices. It sounded like a ton of voices. So either way, man, I'm here for it. I appreciate the request. Patreon friends, see everyone again soon. Have a great evening.